Everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today is the first of the month, and so I am participating in the Scrap Our Stash sketch challenge, and this month's sketch twist is to add circles. So what I'm going to do is stay somewhat true to the sketch as far as picture placement. I have a bunch of scraps that I wanted to use on this. I have a tendency to keep my scraps in categories, and so I sort of pulled out all of my vacation themed scraps, and I'm going to use those. I'm mixing a lot of different manufacturers, a lot of different papers and patterns, and for this particular one I'm going to punch out some circles to kind of make some bubbles. This picture is actually kind of a happy accident. When we were snorkeling in Hawaii back in January, I was of course a scrapbooker, so trying to take photos of my explorations under the water, and I accidentally got a picture of myself. And when I looked at it, I was like, huh, that's kind of fun. So this is sort of a happy accident. And so on the sketch, there's sort of a banner that goes across. And instead of doing that, I am going to use this cut file that I have gone ahead and backed. I just thought it was kind of fun. Looked like kind of the bottom of the sea. And so I'm going to tuck my photo under there rather than actually putting that banner across. So I'm going to go ahead and get that on there, and then I'm going to work on my circles or my bubbles. And I am going to put them in groups of three. So I have a larger circle, a 1-inch circle, and then a smaller circle. And those are going to be kind of representative, at least to me, representative of these bubbles. And I think it works out okay. Hopefully. Anyway, hopefully you get the gist. So I was really happy with the way this was turning out. I really like that scrap paper that had those bubble edges. And that's why I think sometimes it's fun to just throw things into categories, because I would have never looked through that in my stash. And it was just kind of fun to be able to look and decide that, hey, I can use this again. So I'm sure this is a very, very old paper, and I'm just kind of happy that I was able to use it. Speaking of old, I also have these sort of water splash crystals that are from, I can't even pronounce it, Jave Creative. Pardon me if I get it wrong. I don't even know if they're still in business, but I had gotten several of them on clearance, and I think it works very well just to add a little bit of bling here. And I am going to add in my title, which is Snorkel Selfie, and I just cut that out on my Cricut. And so I'm going to put that in. I did do it in black because I wanted it to kind of pop a little bit, and also I did use some black on the cut file and around my photo, and so I did want to add a little bit more black up there. Now I am going to use these sequins by Spiegelmom Scraps, which is brush strokes, just to continue to add more circles as well as more bling to this particular layout. And that's going to be about it for me. Thanks again for stopping by my channel. I will link the challenge information, and I hope that you have an opportunity to participate in this challenge this month. There's always a wonderful prize, and we always appreciate you participating. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. And if you're not yet a subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification button to see what else I have coming up this month. May is May I Scrap Lift You month. And so I will have quite a few things, as well as some International Scrapbook Day celebrations. So make sure that you come check us out. Again, thanks so much for stopping by my channel. Your support is really appreciated. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye, everyone.